Yes, hello everyone. Today I will show you about apartment tour in Japan. It's very beautiful. Let me see this my video. So today at Oknia, today ni kyum dong bang hai mi pet at Oknia om pi pteh luen lekana baep chun chit Japan. So yung chong dong tha ta ka ro nau lekana pteh luen baep lekana chun chit Japan lekana khok ni yang na so tu sana video chmuoy kyum teung Oknia.
Tokyo. However, it's a little bit different from your normal houses, and I've got my friend inside to show us around. So let's check it out. Hey Ryan!
Nice to see you too.
How are you? Thank you for showing me around.
No, no problem, no problem. Thanks for coming. Okay, let me open the door.
Yeah, please open the door for us.
Social apartment. So we kind of take a normal house and then we add on a lot of lounge areas, a lot of public spaces for people to be social in.
Oh wow, so how many people actually live here?
So we have about 130.
130?
130. All in this complex. It's 10 stories tall, so we can pack a lot of people.
Okay, well let's go check out the rest of the house.
Well, it's the first place that I want to show you is the lounge right here.
This is not what you normally see when you first go into the lounge.
We got the billiard table. If you look above it, we actually have this projector right here.
Wow, okay.
So we have a 120-inch projector screen. So you can watch movies, play games, things of that sort. Wii U and all of that. There's no need to buy your own. Moving on, we have kind of a dining area right here. So this is a great place for people to gather. We try to make these big long tables so you can sit here and you can have your little kanpai, things like that. And then a nice television over here too, so when you want to watch something a little more quiet. And it links into this kitchen right here. These nice island kitchens right here. So, you know in Tokyo we have these like tiny kitchens?
I was just gonna say, like the first thing I thought about this place is it's huge, the kitchen.
No, yeah. Right? For sure. And it's nice because you have actual counter space.
You actually so have like a big sink where you can like
wash your dishes
and
actually make things, make preparations. When I first moved here, I had a little kitchen and there was one burner and then the little sink, and then I was cutting things off of the refrigerator. So here you don't have to deal with that. And here we also provide all the pots and pans, everything.
Okay, great.
So everything's brand new.
Wow.
So you're free to use it however much you want.
Yeah, I mean it's very clean despite, you know, 130
people
living here.
Well, that's mostly thanks to us, I think. So we actually have cleaning staff come through 5 times a week.
Great.
So they clean all the kitchens, everything. Most people are Japanese actually that live here.
Oh, most people are Japanese.
Yeah, and so they're very courteous. And they're very good about washing their stuff and putting it away.
I think one comment I would get is it okay if you don't speak Japanese and you live in a place like here?
No. Actually, every time I come here, people say hi and hello, and they don't speak Japanese with me anymore here. So there's actually a lot of people who speak English, and a lot of people who actually move into social apartments in these kind of places, they're looking to learn English, use English.
Right.
So if you don't speak Japanese, it's okay. It's perfectly fine. This is the place to learn.
You actually got me at
Japanese people. We actually have a lot of these high brand items too. We do a lot of collaborations with people.
That's very expensive. I do not want to break it.
No, these are very expensive. Touching it is very scary for me as well. This is a $200 toaster.
Oh wow, $200 toaster. I mean, it's really good for people who just moved to Tokyo and you know, they don't have any furniture. It's really big hassle to like buy everything.
Yeah, you don't realize when you're moving somewhere how much that little stuff adds up.
Even just a cup.
Even just a cup.
I like how you've got the world neighbors on this.
That's how we keep those here. So we go ahead and we like
don't steal the cups. Let's go around here. What's here?
So, because we do have 130 rooms and it's 10 stories tall, taking stuff from the kitchen to your room can be a bit of a pain.
Definitely, yeah.
So So we provide this storage area. Every room has its own box right here.
Oh, yeah.
This is the perfect size for like pasta, rice.
Right. How about like the rubbish and everything? Who deals with that?
The rubbish, we deal with all the rubbish from here. So we actually take care of taking that out 5 times a week when the cleaning staff comes.
5 times a week you take
out? 5 times a week we take out the rubbish.
When we work in Tokyo, a lot of people tend to be very busy with their lives, their jobs. So it's less of that people.
It really takes a lot off of you. And then we find that when you take out the issues of who's going to clean when and who's going to clean what and how are you going to clean it, then people can start focusing on the fun parts of living with each other, which is let's cook a meal together, let's eat dinner together, let's watch TV. And so your conversations stop being about what needs to get done and what you want to do.
That's very true. Like, you stop fighting over who's going to do what or who didn't do what.
When me and my roommate fight, it's always about cleaning.
You gotta move here.
Yeah, I've thought about it a lot, actually. So next we're gonna go into another lounge area.
Another lounge area?
Yes. So this is kind of the dining social area.
Where are we at?
Right now we're gonna go check out the working lounge. So for people who work from home or people who are studying, things like that, we actually provide a separate space. So let's take a peek inside real quick.
Cafe.
We call it World Neighbors Cafe. Let's take a look.
Oh, this is the life living in one of these places.
It's open to the public. So we think this is a real great place for people who live here to actually interact with people who live in their neighborhood.
Oh, to interact with the local. That's the best.
And actually specialize in hot sandwiches,
yum,
pickles, sour drinks, things like that.
So it's perfect if you don't want to cook.
And everyone who lives here actually has 5,000 yen of credit for the cafe, included in their rent every month.
Thank you for showing me around.
Of course.
I'm enjoying what I'm seeing so far. You're making me actually want to move here.
Oh, they're still open. They're still open. We can talk after.
The orange is really good with the sandwich.
So, we have one more thing that's connected to the cafe here. And that's going to be the laundromat.
This is where all the people wash their clothes.
So we have a separate free laundry for people who live here.
Free laundry.
But this is open to the public. And if you really want to get your stuff clean, this is the best place. The good thing about this is actually we have 2 times a month a laundry service.
Wow, that's awesome.
No, so we have 2 times a month our staff comes and picks up your laundry. They take it down here and they clean it in the good machines for free.
Yeah.
And then you can pick it up the next day.
So they dry it and then
fold
it?
They dry it, fold it, they do everything.
Oh god, this is perfect for like lazy people.
And we'll go ahead and we'll hop up to the gym floor.
Yay! Finally we can check out the room!
Yes. The most important part of everything.
Come on in, come on in! And how many rooms is that?
So we have a total of 130 rooms. Some of those are furnished and some of those aren't furnished.
Okay.
So especially Japanese people, they want unfurnished rooms because they already have all their stuff.
Okay.
For people coming from overseas, having a furnished room really makes it easy for them. And here we are on the 10th floor.
Oh my god, you didn't tell me about this.
No, I didn't, but that's okay.
Wow!
Now this is our roof terrace.
Wow! Okay, so before the room, we're gonna sky tree!
I'd keep it a surprise.
Wow, this is lovely. You can have a barbecue.
Yeah, you can have a barbecue up here. Yeah, so it's got its own kitchen, its own bathroom, your own private space, everything all laid out there.
Yeah, because this just looks like a normal apartment that you usually go to.
No, exactly.
The layout and everything.
So, this will be our mama room right here. So not all rooms have furnishings, and some of the furnishings will look a little different from this.
Yeah.
But this is kind of our model of what it looks like once you move in.
You've got your own kitchen, but it's very small compared to the one downstairs.
Yeah, we were talking about kind of when you first move to Tokyo and you have a tiny kitchen.
Yeah.
This is it.
Yeah.
But this is perfect for if you don't want to go downstairs and you want to make some pasta or you want to make some tea, something like that. It's perfect to have right here for yourself.
Ta-da!
Once I get the lights right.
Nice. It's very spacious. How big is the place?
So in total, it's going to be about 20 square meters. In this part right here, the actual living area, you're looking at about 8 tummy mats.
Oh, okay.
It's a pretty spacious room.
Yeah. Especially for Japanese.
Especially for Japanese. The standard is kind of the 6-mat room.
Yeah.
So this is a pretty spacious one. It's also really nice in here because the ceilings are nice and
high. Yeah, I was going to say, because how tall are you?
I'm about 183 centimeters.
Yeah, normally the Japanese rooms, the ceilings, like, you gotta be like,
it's great. I can walk in and I don't have to do the awkward.
Yeah.
So let me push that up and then pull it.
Right, would you like to do me the honor?
Of course. I've had a little bit of practice.
Look at that beautiful sunset. So this here is just to protect, this net.
We're right by a park, so Japan has its fair share of pigeons.
Oh, that's nice though. You get a nice view, not just like normal apartments where you open your window and you see the building right next door, right?
No, you get actually have open space so sunlight can come in.
Yeah, sunlight, very important. I think what everyone is wondering is probably how much is this room?
It would be about, I'd say about 100,000 to 110,000 here. And so that's going to include everything like water, electricity, and things like that, as well as the services we talked about, so 5,000 yen cafe credit, and that's also going to be the laundry service twice a month, cleaning comes through, everything like that. So that includes everything that we already talked about for that 110,000.
So if you already live in central Tokyo, you have to pay around, I think the average is around Juma, right?
In this area, you're going to be looking at a cute Juma.
Yeah, it's around that price.
So this is a normal apartment in Kiyosumi Shirakawa, plus all of the extra amenities we already want.
That's what I really like.
So you're really on the cheap end. We also have other properties, though, that aren't in the heart of Tokyo.
Yeah.
And they're going to be a little bit cheaper in that 60, 70 range.
Right, and I actually went to one to play beer pong. Right?
No, I remember that. Every room has its own bathroom as well.
Ooh, so you don't have to share.
So you don't have to share. These are all new fixtures and everything.
I mean, it's Japan, you can't, you know, ask for a big bathroom.
No. At some point, Tokyo reality sets in. It's perfect. You can put some CGI in there.
Yeah, CGI. I like it. It's a cozy little apartment.
Yes.
Alright.
Well, now that it's gotten kind of dark, we can go to my favorite part of the whole place. That's the bar. This is a great place to invite friends. This is a great place to interact with your housemates and stuff. It's also just like a real nice place to just have a nice chill evening by yourself if you want it. It's really great. We provide all of this shelf space for people to bring their own alcohol and display it and things like that.
Ooh, display it.
We actually, I heard that there's some residents who are actually coming by here if you want to talk to them.
Oh, like to here?
Yeah, to here in the bar. There's some sort of event tonight, actually.
Ooh, yeah.
We can probably round up some people right now, so.
Cool. Awesome. Let's do that.
Cool. Thank you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
What's your name?
James.
James. Oh, where are you from?
Sydney, Australia.
Pizza Kanpai.
Pizza Kanpai.
Australia.
I'm from Lithuania.
Kumamoto.
Kyushu.
Kumamoto no hito tte hito oi.
Why here?
This is the best place, like in terms of the price, for the size versus other places in Tokyo. Having access to like the bar and the lounge and the kitchen and having a good community of people. And it kind of, when we got here, we met everyone. Everyone was super nice.
Right.
I think that's a really important thing when you go to the country.
How about you guys?
Osaka, Shushu.
Japanese.
Yeah, like, I mean, I met a few, people who speak English, and even if, like, Moka here, he speaks Japanese over 3 minutes.
He's like,
yeah.
No comment. Also, I guess the Japanese people, even though some of them don't speak English, they're still very open to meeting foreigners, learning English, learning about different cultures, and on the other side, it's great for you guys to meet actual locals.
Watching this my video, please subscribe YouTube channel to get more this video. Aku pun video ini sebab nak tambah tu senang video. Bukan cuma semua boleh cuy subscribe YouTube channel. Bukan cuma pun video tu bang video tu baik tiap aku jarang.